setting for the year. During this month, I then fine tune these goals, and then I go into action with my QLA war plan, like it was my last 2 minutes of my last Super Bowl. World Cup of my life, I made it fucking happen. Failure is not an option. Here are a few guidelines for goal setting. As usual, conventional wisdom is wrong on many points. Disregard what I write at your own peril. Written, reviewed, changed, and affirmed. Goals should be written and reviewed often. Early in my career, I read my goals twice daily, along with all my various positive affirmations. Now I read goals monthly and affirmations daily before I go to bed. I check off the goals accomplished. I also change or adjust goals monthly. This is not a new ability, and athletes of all descriptions have been, this is not a new technique, have been following this procedure forever. I can't emphasize too strongly how important and powerful affirmations in the morning upon waking and just before you go to bed, go to sleep, are in fulfilling your goals and dreams. No time limits. Conventional wisdom says set time limits. I put no time limits on goal setting. In fact, I always say your goals must be accomplished as soon as humanly possible, ASAP. I have found time limits act as deterrents rather than benchmarks. Similarly, in school, you were given so much time to get something done. By God, it took you that much time. I also found limits allow you to agree with conventional wisdom much too easily. I was told countless times, don't be in such a hurry. You are way ahead of schedule now. I didn't listen much to that, thank God. Not realistic. Be audacious. Another conventional precept is the notion of setting realistic goals. Of course, this is advised so you don't feel badly and discouraged when you don't accomplish your goals. Guess what? If you are not risking anything, you don't have significant incentive to do whatever it takes to get the job completed. If the goal and actions to achieve them aren't taking you out of your comfort zone, they aren't making you really stretch. And by now you know what the fuck I mean when I say I am committed to something, lol. In the future, I will write about how your lack of commitment has held you back in being all you can be. Personal goals. I have had two sets of personal goals dating back to 1976. One, goals that I talk about and may have some other participants. And two, what Jim Newman used to call under the skin goals. The later goals are very private and are shared with only your significant other and mentor. These under the skin goals are a very personal nature that are only shared with those that will provide encouragement and support. If your partner in life does not share your enthusiasm, don't share and consider a new partner. These special goals at times may seem of an embarrassing nature but are of extreme importance to your current well-being and success. And yes, if your partner is not part of your goal scheme, it has little chance of succeeding. My experience is in most relationships, both personal and business, bust up because goals are different. Of course, if your partner has the same goals but a different level of sacrifice they are willing to endure, partnership will almost also bust up. Family goals. My family goals have varied over the years based on where my children were in their own life cycles. Many of these goals should be jointly set when the kids are young, and children's goals for themselves will vary a great deal. But if you get them in the habit of setting goals, they will by default get in the habit of achieving goals. As your family grows, so do your goals. I learned my ideas of what my children should do varied greatly from what they thought they should do. With any kind of goal setting, positive reinforcement is a must. As Plato said, as long as progress is made, no matter how slowly, never discourage. I would differ with the great master on slowness, as any of my mentees would tell you, Dan is not big on being slow except when having sex, lol. Pena, personal goals. As many of you know, my father's only goal for me was to keep me alive until I reached the age of reason. For me, this came later than most. My military experience changed my life. Though I knew what sacrifice and integrity meant intellectually from childhood, from my father, I didn't really understand the emotional commitment necessary to succeed. When I was deemed an officer and a gentleman by an act of the United States Congress, it meant a massive turning point in my life. Discipline. Discipline. What discipline and integrity meant. It still means a great deal to me even now. This was an under-the-skin goal, though I didn't call it that back then, that I shared with no one. In those days, I had no mentor or significant other. At that time, I knew my life would have little or no meaning the way I was headed. I had no focus, so I took a big risk. I stretched way outside my existing comfort zone, I volunteered for an additional stint in the US Army by going for officer training. Actually, it was the second step of my under the skin goal of making something myself. I had already volunteered to go into the Army at the height of the Vietnam War. My father had told me the military has straightened out countless young men before me, and he added, if you can make it, son, be an officer. I didn't share with anyone. I had volunteered till I was out of the Army. The bottom line is it worked. The rest is history, as they say. Business goals. They are no different than the family and personal goals. You follow the same pattern. The only difference is you will undoubtedly find more wrong advice than you can ever imagine. Most people have something to say about things they know a little about. They know little about, like having kids and raising them, etc. The same is true of your personal goals. After all, everyone has lived a little and learned something about life, but when it comes to business, every dog on the street has some crap to say. From the guy in the post office to the high school football coach, they all have some comment, and the problem is we listen to them because we don't know much about business ourselves. Therefore, if you get nothing more from this blog, unless the person giving business advice has been there and done what you aspire to do, don't listen. Remember, even the average accountant, CPA, chartered accountant, and lawyer only makes less than $100,000 per annum. So, if you want more than that, don't ask. The same goes for parents, in-laws, brothers, sisters, kids, and colleagues. Unless your name is Buffett, Branson, Perot, Rockefeller, or Gate, forget about listening to them. Of course, you can read all my free content on my site or other QLA material on Torrent. What I have written is meant to be a few succinct points on goal setting. I've written and talked much about this topic over the years. My current experience is that people who set goals use only average benchmarks. Yes, almost all people set goals too low. They do this due to their lack of self-esteem and not wanting to get out of their comfort zone. It is also due to listening to people that have set unfulfilled goals themselves. And goal setting is an art, not a science. Wake up call. More than anything, this blog is meant as a wake up call for you to take fucking action for this year. This is a great time to dream it, think it, and do it, as Bill Gates would say. Take action to evoke positive changes in your life. So, in the words of my mentor, Jim Newman, release your brakes. He believed, and I concur, most people go through life due to lack of self-esteem, filled with self-doubt, with their emergency brake on. Hence, not fulfilling anywhere near their full human potential and not being all you can be to your quantum leap in life and business.